From coast to coast and around the world, it's time to praise the Lord. Praise the Lord covers the major Christian events in America and across the world, from the heart of Europe. To the tip of Africa. From the centers of Asia. To Central and South America. You're part of the world's largest prayer and praise network. Join us on Praise the Lord from Cleveland, Akron, and Kenton, Ohio, as we bring you anointed pastors, evangelists, teachers, authors, and other special guests with testimonies and teaching to encourage and inspire, and music to glorify God as we lift up Jesus Christ as Lord.
And he took off the condition. He took off that thing that signified who he was. And he began to rise up and begin to let people know, I'm not going to be this way anymore. See, today you got to rise up. You got to rise up by faith. Because faith is stepping out on nothing and nothing becomes something. My God. Because when you rise up and begin to stand up and begin to declare, today's my day, today's my moment. And right now, see, you may be going through a financial situation, but stand up and say, I may not have no money right now in my pocket, but I thank God money's on the way. Doctors may have diagnosed me with sickness, but thank God. I may have that condition of sickness, but I'm coming out because the word said, by his stripes, I am healed. See, I remember the story, hearing my grandma tell the story about her being sick with cancer. For 12 months, she had suffered with cancer, just kept getting worse and worse and worse. And she went from around 150 pounds down to 90 pounds, almost like the snap of your finger. And I noticed as here my grandma was, as she's getting weaker and weaker as the days went by. But there was something about my grandma was that she would take the word of God for what the word of God said. What I like to call crazy faith. What people says, well, I don't know really if that. Your faith is what you believe and how much you believe it. And if you'll step out, see, we need some people that'll step out on some crazy faith today. She stood out and began to take the word of God, and she found every scripture that said in the word of God that by his stripes I'm healed. And when she began to, all of a sudden, she began to speak the word of God, and her body kept getting weaker and the condition kept getting stronger. And people began to say, and Ruth, you're going to die. You're going to die. And she was one of them old time Pentecostal holiness women. And as me and Pastor Tim was speaking about earlier, and she didn't have the means to go to the doctor and keep going back and back, and because of finances and things like that. But she was also a believer, and that if you stand on the word of God and speak the word of God and don't waver, don't back up, but declare it. Declare a thing today. It's time we decree a thing and stand upon it, because if you decree it, it's going to manifest. And so she began to decree, I am healed. I am healed. And she would write on the walls where she would fix my dad and his sister's food and things like that. And she would write on the wall, by his stripes, I'm healed. She would go through the house, laying by her bed. She had scriptures wrote on paper all over the place, all through the house during this season of her life, during this season of turns, forwards and backwards. What looked like was coming out, but then the setback would come. But all of a sudden, she got so weak that she couldn't go on any farther in the flesh. And she told my grandpa, they lived behind the church at that time. And she said, Clyde, she said, I am going into the church and I'm going to begin to pray. And he said, I'm going there. I don't want anybody to bother me. She kissed the kids goodbye. He packed her down to the church, set her on the altar in the church, in that old church, locked the door, went home, got in bed, left her all alone, just her by herself in that building. But in a few moments after he had went to sleep, he said he was awakened up out of sleep. And as he was awakened up out of sleep, he said he began to hear music and singing. And he told her, I promised her I will not let anybody come in bother you while you're in here praying and seeking God. All of a sudden, he gets dressed, runs down the side of the church, and looks through a window. And realizes that the singing and the music is a catchiest, is a coming from inside. But hovered over top of that church building was angels singing the praises of God. He opens the door and runs in, and there is his 90-pound wife running back across the front of that church saying, guess what happened, Clyde? I have been healed. Said it felt like warm water went from the top of my head to the sole of my feet. And listen, her condition changed when she stood upon the word of God. Today is your day for victory. Today is your day to come out of what you've been in, because the moment of coming out is right now. This is our now moment. Hallelujah. When you get the vision, all of a sudden, he's going to produce the provision that's in our life. Bartimaeus may have lost his eyes, but catch this. He said, Lord, that I may receive my sight. In other words, that I may get my vision back. They may be some men of God and women of God that's sitting right now watching this, that you may have said, I've been kicked out. This has happened. This has went wrong. A condition has become what you are known by now. And listen, your ministry may seem like it's over. But I come to tell somebody today, some man, some woman, some boy or girl, today is your day of hope. Rise up. You can do it. They may not believe in you, but Christ has said, I believe in you. You can do it. You can make it. Today is your day. Don't allow the condition to affect your position. So Bartimaeus said that I may get my vision back. That I may get my vision back. See, he lost his eyes. But see, the power of life and death isn't in the eyes. It's in the power of the tongue. And when you begin to start speaking, see, you may have to...